up with their boobs? They look like they have, like, giant pimples on them.
Oh my god, they do.
I mean, I guess that's supposed to be a highlight, but highlight... That's not how light works, you guys.
Oh, we're recording. Hi, everyone. My name is Rainbow. This is Mexi.
Hey!
And this is our anniversary special.
Part two!
Part two. We're playing Sakura Spirit. And this game was actually recommended to me as, like, one of those, like, worst games to play. And we're, like, and since we're huge feminists, of course we have to play this game.
Play this completely... objectifying, terrible game.
Yeah, we have to love it, of course.
Okay, look at... Okay, redhead?
Yeah.
Look at her arm. It is way too short.
Oh my god, it is.
That's the other thing, is that when you're an artist, you notice, like...
Yeah, screw the feminist stuff. This is all, like, all we're gonna be doing is, like, that's not how the boobs work. That's not how that's shaped. That's not where the arm goes. The ribcage doesn't make that
Or, like,
shape.
Oh my god, back problems. Like, okay, my... I'm gonna ruin everything for everybody right now. My boobs are huge, and they cause me really terrible back issues. So all I can think of is all these poor girls.
Yeah,
they
really
got back problems.
Her boobs do look nice, though. Alright, apparently we're having sex with that one.
I don't think they can see the cursor, can they?
I don't know. We'll find out. It's the fox...
with purple eyes.
The purple-eyed fox.
So. I like that one.
Every person has a dream they wish to pursue.
I always wanted to stick it in a fox girl.
Really?
That was my dream. Yeah.
Okay. And yet, as people grow up, they often come to realize the truth. Dreams are nothing more than fairy tales.
That's true.
At least that's what most people say.
So I still could stick it in a fox girl.
You could. Anything is possible with God.
Or dating sims.
Go. Okay. Are you loading?
It's probably loading.
Oh. Then what about those who do end up accomplishing their dreams? Are they merely incredibly lucky?
Capitalism! Every man has a dream he wants to accomplish. I guess I'm dad.
Oh, are we a dude?
Yeah.
Right. I'm sorry. Hang on. All right, you're dad. Go.
Every man has a dream he wants to accomplish. However, there's something really important you should know, my boy. A real man doesn't give up on his dream no matter what overwhelming challenges he might have to face. Now remember, our dream is to stick it in a fox girl. That's our dream.
Can we not say that?
Why? I mean, this game's terrible. We might as well just go all the way.
Alright, let's be horrible. Let's be absolutely nutcase horrible.
Yeah.
I still remember those foolish words my dad... I'm gonna say this in an ultra girly voice too.
Mm-hmm.
Just for fun.
Okay.
I still remember those foolish words my dad used to say.
No, don't do that.
I could do a really good Valley Girl.
Please don't.
All right.
Please don't.
I still remember those foolish words my dad used to say, but despite their silly nature, I found myself inspired by them.
Really?
Ever since I was a young child, I have been interested in martial arts.
Oh, are you gonna have an actual dream? Dang it!
It didn't matter whether I watched a match on television or read a manga about it, about some heroic martial artist. It's always been my dream to become a martial artist one day. Of course, it was a bit childish of me to think that. I could become a hero simply by learning martial arts. Even though I already understood that superheroes were nothing more than figments of my imagination, I still had the desire to use my strength for the sake of others. My name is this.
Gushiken Takahito.
A 17-year-old rising judo star. And no, that's not me bragging. I'm actually about to take part in a tournament 2 weeks from now, and I could make or break my career on an international level. Of course, I was excited about the opportunities to finally accomplish my dreams and represent my country at a sport that I loved, but the same excitement also made me feel incredibly nervous. And while those worrisome thoughts haunted my mind, a familiar voice resounded from outside the window.
Oi! Taka-kun! Get your butt in gear!
Okay, I'll be right there, Koyomi.
Koyomi.
I'm glad you speak Japanese. Not wanting to keep Koyomi. Waiting, I quickly dashed towards the door to let her in, not even realizing I was still in my
Naked.
Pajamas.
Oh, okay. Pajamas.
Hold on a second, Koyomi. Grabbing some of my shoes before I head off to school.
Really? I never realized your school had a strict uniform or sleepwear policy. Nice jammies, by the way. Did you borrow them from your mom?
For a moment, my eyes drifted downwards, noticing that I was indeed wearing my pajamas. I let out a groan of annoyance and marched back towards my room. Ugh, there's nothing wrong with jammies. The Golden Knight is a famous comic book hero in the West. Besides, not everyone prefers to sleep naked like you.
Oh, excuse you!
Mumbly as those words, I started stripping out of my clothes, not particularly minding the presence of the girl behind me.
Wow, alright, you're just gonna strip down.
Is she one of them?
I don't know. That only happened once! You know very well it was super hot that night, and geez, warn me before you strip naked in front of me, you idiot. This is our childhood friend.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she looks like the childhood friend. You didn't seem to mind when we were little. Maybe you want me to turn around instead. What?
What? No, stop! Don't make me kick your ass!
I decided to I had teased her enough and quickly pulled my pants on, proceeding with the remaining few items of clothing before I was suitably dressed for school. Besides, I had a reason to be so distracted.
Was it my boobs?
Yeah.
You've been distracted a lot lately. What's been going in that hollow skull of yours?
It's the upcoming match. I have no idea how anyone can remain calm when an international career is at stake. I wouldn't be surprised if I had made up enough doomsday scenarios to fill up the apocalypse genre.
Oh, right, the judo thing. I'm sure you'll do fine. I've seen some of your matches, and you kick butt. Of course, if you're really worried, you could always pray.
When does the sex happen?
I don't know.
I thought you played these before.
I played Otome games, not these.
Oh. Pray?
But don't tell me you don't know. It's one of the school's legends. Apparently, there's some shrine out in the forest that if you pray to, it brings you good luck.
Oh, okay. So okay. It's gonna pray.
You're gonna pray, and then all these sexy fox demon girls are gonna come out
and try to get your pants. Yeah, that's what it is. Okay, got it.
Ichikawa-san said that his sister prayed to it the night before her exam, and she got a perfect score because she was having lots of. She was lessing it up with the little demon girls, that's why! She was real happy that next morning! we're gonna put a disclaimer that this is terrible.
This is terrible, and we're being worse. A shrine that's said to bring you good luck sounds like bogus to me. Sounds like bogus to me?
Yeah, like bull honky.
Well, I know what bogus means, but that's not the... Okay, whatever.
Well, bogus can be a noun or a verb. Adjective?
I've never heard it used it that way. Anyway, but at this point, I'm willing to try anything, I guess. I'll ask... Ichikawa, about the location. I'm not exactly in the mood to get lost in the forest and end up in modern day Tarzan.
How do you feel about Inuyasha? Well, whatever. If you do go looking, at least send me a message to let me know. And will you hurry up? We're gonna be late again!
A hero is never too early, nor are they too late. They arrive precisely when they need to. Did you just make a Lord of the Rings reference?
I was going to if they weren't.
But for the sake of avoiding detention, let's hurry.
You are not Gandalf. Let's get that straight. You are not Gandalf. That's a wizard, not a hero genius. How can one person be such a sports nerd and such a geek at the same time?
Let's not forget Casanova, the Man of the Year candidate bits their important details.
I doubt you qualify for either of them, Pajama Boy.
Anyway, let's boldly go where everyone has gone before, to school!
Okay, so we already have a Lord of the Rings reference and a Star Trek reference.
Yeah.
Ugh, nerd!
Several hours later. Oh good, we're skipping school. Multiple ellipses. Later that day, I finally got a chance to talk to my classmate about the location of the shrine that Koyomi had mentioned earlier. Gym was the last thing on the schedule for today, so once people got ready to go home, I approached the guy. Hey, I have a Japanese.
Ichikawa,
is it true that your sister discovered some shrine that is said to bring you good luck? Oh, I like him.
Hang on. No, I'm eating chocolate.
He's cute. Can we romance him?
No, we gotta romance Fox Girl.
Oh, let me guess, you want to date her. Well, even though I have to admit that she's very attractive, I'm afraid she's already going out with somebody.
These games are weird.
Not to mention, you're not her type.
I already got my hands full dealing with Koyomi. You can keep your sister to yourself. Joke aside, I'm more interested in that shrine. Did she mention where she found it? I don't know where there was anything near the forest aside from the dojo.
Oh, well, she said something about being near a river and quite high up. To be honest, I wasn't paying much attention when she was going on about it. I mean, she was wearing this top and it was tight and...
This is your sister! Stop! Seriously, I just need to hear the details. I don't need to hear the details, and I doubt anyone else is interested. So, do you know anyone who might have heard about the shrine?
Are you guys talking about the lucky shrine out in the forest?
The one and only. According to Ichikawa's sister, there's supposed to be one near a river. Please stop making that face.
I don't know about that, but there's a fiery girl at the Asakura Dojo who knows more about it. Wait, are you talking about Ariya-sama? That's this tall, ridiculously strong, and super scary? That's the one! Oh, in that case, I believe I can still be of help. Takahito-kun, I know where that place is. God, you're a creeper.
Yeah, never mind, you're not cute anymore. Of course you do. We both do. You just want to tag along, don't you? I don't think Ariya-senpai will appreciate you visiting her with your usual tricks in mind. I don't need to remind you what happened last time you tried to peek in her after she finished practice. Oh, gross! Never mind, you're not cute at all. Blood, sweat, and tears.
Shut up! I don't peep on the ladies, that's slander, you know? I should sue you! I would never look up Ariya-sama's glorious body in any state of nudity.
So you haven't seen her naked yet?
I've seen a bit of side boob, but the hole I found didn't really let me get a good view of...
There we go. Someone call the cops. Ichikawa's the peeping Tom has confessed. I playfully patted Ichikawa's shoulder as I turned around, grabbing my bag in the process and prepared to leave. Thanks for the tip, Ichikawa. I'll let the judge know you were most helpful during the interrogation.
This is unfair! I was coerced! I won't say another word until I speak with my lawyer! You're like 15, kid!
Yeah, really. Ellipses. More ellipses. More ellipses. Once school's over, I decide to take my chances with a little bit of intel I had managed to obtain from my classmates. If memory served me right, Ariya-senpai would be practicing in the dojo today. Of course I knew her. She was the judo student just like myself, but for whatever reason, she's been refusing to compete in any tournament for a while now. Ariya-senpai, are you around? I shouted her name as I parked my bike, looking around for any sign of the girl.
Ha! Ha! Yeah!
Hey, follow the shouts and you will find her. I grinned briefly as I saw Ariya seemingly in the middle of practicing a series of motions, almost as if she was fighting an imaginary opponent. Perhaps now was a perfect opportunity to surprise her a little? No.
No. You're gonna get a broken nose.
I hope I get a broken nose. I snuck closer, making sure to make as little noise as possible before I reached a hand towards her shoulder. Ariya. Feeling the hand on her shoulder, Ariya reacted, grabbed hold of my hand, and with a loud grunt, shifted her weight, curling and tipping me over her shoulder. Good. I didn't have time to brace myself for the impact before I hit the ground like a sack of potatoes.
Good, now you have cracked ribs.
Aw, you're cute.
Yeah! No one sneaks up on the great Kunoichi Ariya! Oh, Takaboy, I didn't realize it was you. I'm sorry, are you okay?
No, don't apologize, I was being an Konichi? More like...
Kunoichi.
More like Tasmanian devil. That throw didn't have a shred of mercy in it. You deserved it.
Yeah. There's no mercy in the ring, Takaboy. Better you learn that now than in 2 weeks' time. Let me guess, you want to do some sparring, don't you?
Actually, I came here to ask you something, but I guess a little sparring wouldn't hurt. Now get on with the stupid story.
What did you want to ask? We've got all afternoon. I could do with a bit of a break anyway.
Where to start? You used to take part in the big and important matches in the past, right? Didn't you ever get nervous before going into the ring?
Oh yeah, there's one time I got so nervous I hid in the kitchen cupboards until my dad found me and dragged me to the car. Of course, that was when I was like 8.
Well, obviously I can't go hide from my match, but one of my friends made the stupid suggestion that I go and pray or something. Honestly, at this point, I'll do anything to calm my nerves a little.
Taka Boy, are you sure about this?
Why are you blushing? You mean the match? Of course I am. I've been practicing judo ever since I was old enough to walk. This is my chance to finally represent this country and the sport I love. Aria seemed to think for quite a long time, all the while tapping her jaw with a finger. Eventually, she snapped her fingers and grabbed tight hold of me.
Alright, I'll tell you the way to the shrine I know, but it's gonna require more than a simple clap of hands and bob of your head. You need to give something to that shrine, something of value.
My penis? I guess I have to think about something before I get there. Thanks, Senpai, I appreciate the help.
No, Taka Boy, I'm not going with you. I've got training to do. Besides, you've got to take this step yourself. I can draw you a map and show you an easy way to get back here, but you're on your own.
You're not tagging along? Not even for a little while?
Afraid so, Taka Boy. Let me just grab some paper. I'll draw that map for you.
After Aria's return, quick preparations were made and I followed the direction noted on the map. Surprisingly, it wasn't all that far. However, the hint on how to find my way back in case I got lost was a bit sketchy. Just look down, you'll be able to see the roof of the dojo from anywhere on the hill. Oh, okay. The forest near the dojo was my first challenge to overcome. The narrow path coiled along the trees, and nearby was the river
Ichikawa's
sister had mentioned. I followed Aria's scribbles with a bit of skepticism, but after an hour or so, I finally arrived at the supposedly legendary shrine. What?
I don't know, man. Okay.
It's like a tiny theme park with a ghost. It's with a ghost theme and it's haunted.
Oh, foolish! No doubt it has nothing but tricks to scare mere children. We shall not enter.
We shall.
We shall enter? No, we shall not!
Oh, hey, wait! Oh, he's gonna die.
What trickery is this? I can't see! Why